You are watching the Legislative Council Legal and Social Issues Committee's public hearing for the inquiry into the management of child sex offender information.
The issue of data quality is a very important one, particularly so in this very sensitive context where incorrect data can have some very harmful effects, both to the systems but also, of course, to individuals.
Probably the leading thing we would like to see happen, or the committee to recommend, is that AUSTRAC is given direct access to the Victorian Sex Offender Register. We do have some concerns, though, about if the committee was to have a mind to making the current Sex Offender Register public.
And one of the key messages there, and again, I think this is where registers miss the mark. One of the key messages needs to be that there is a child sex offender in every postcode.
Registered sex offenders are growing on the register around 500 per annum. Given that, do you think that data integrity or quality concerns would eventuate given the rise in those numbers per annum?
The more data you hold and the longer you hold it, the bigger the risk. Now, there might be really good reasons for holding a lot of data for a long time, but it comes at a cost. And I'm not talking about the monetary cost of storage, I'm talking about the cost of the risk.
What my understanding is that once the data is collected and it goes on the register, the child sex offence register, it stays there for an indefinite period.
My view would be a person should stay on the register for as long as they pose a reasonable risk, and as long as there's an assessment that there's a benefit for law enforcement agencies to have access to the information.
Do you report publicly the level of breaches or...
We report the number of incidents, we don't, and we report the severity of incidents. For obvious reasons, we don't tend to report the detail of those incidences. What we do have, one of the weaknesses, I think, in Victorian legislation is that in our Privacy Act, there is no positive obligation to notify people whose information may have been breached. We encourage agencies to notify individuals, but there is no positive obligation in our Act. There is in many other jurisdictions.
What do you think, if the register is publicly available, what would be the impact on the rate of recidivism?
For the bulk of people who've sexually offended against children, this type of public exposure is overreach and will actually stigmatise that group very profoundly. And we know very clearly from the research that stigmatisation exacerbates a whole range of things that are associated with reoffending.
In your view, is there a particular sex offender information which should be kept confidential within any type of scheme?
If information is made public, then obviously the photographs of the offenders can be provided as well. And I think one of the last things you'd want as a victim is to be walking down the street and see the photo of your offender staring back at you. Mm. I think there's certainly a risk there of continued trauma for the survivors. And I think that's something that we generally think is the most important thing to manage.
Have you looked at the WA scheme, and do you have any comments on that?
Publicly exposing people who have sexually offended against children comes with a whole host of, you know, potentially negative outcomes. And so I think that more cautious approach that Western Australia has in place is certainly a better model.
Do you still hold some of the same concerns about any model?
The problem with these kind of registers is their inclusivity, if you like, that everyone sort of gets tarred with the same brush, irrespective of the circumstances of their offending, you know, irrespective of their age, and all of these other things. And that can be very damaging in terms of, you know, minimising the risk that person poses.
What we would argue is, you know, the release of information needs to be evidence-based, and the assessment of clear likely benefit needs to outweigh the clear likely risks of negative consequences.
To everyone involved, I will now bring this hearing to a close. Thank you.